a topic that has been long in discussion amongst the Elder Scrolls community: Saadia, or the Alik'r warriors. Who was right? Which side is politically and morally right on the story told from both sides to you? Did Saadia really sell out a Hammerfell city to the Dominion, or are the Alik'r just a band of dirty mercenaries? Well, there was a lot of detail to both of these sides, but not enough detail to really come to a big conclusion on who was right and who was wrong. I am going to go over two different sections during the videos. Actually, three technically. I am going to do Saadia's story, then the Alik'r. Didn't finish with a final verdict, but it's important to know that to this day, after nearly 7 years, there is still no sure answer. But it hasn't stopped speculation all around the world, so we can go off of that speculation and my own. Mostly my own, but prepare yourselves, as I really do think you will learn some new stuff during this video. If you do, then make sure to leave a like or dislike on this video. It lets me know how you feel on it and the type of content I produce. It really motivates me to go and make more, so other than that, do it for my eek. Don't you love the Khajiit like me? But without further delay, let's get into this and figure out some stuff on this whole topic and who is right and who is wrong. So the quest you will be given in your journal to do is a side quest called In My Time of Need, and it's quite simple. The quest will start when you are approached by two Alik'r warriors at the front of Whiterun who are looking for a Redguard woman and will ask you to help. Coin is the promised reward if you pull through for them. You can also gain the quest by finding Alik'r warriors aggressively talking to random Redguards around the map. It's quite a low level quest, around level 3 or 4 or something, but it's at the front of Whiterun for a guarantee. The Redguard you are looking for is Saadia. She is in the Bannared Mare, working as a maiden on the side, helping in the kitchen and serving food and drink. When approached by you asking her about the Alik'r, she panics and asks you to meet her upstairs, where she goes on to pull a knife out and threaten you. After calming down, she claims that the Alik'r are assassins hired by the Dominion to kill her for publicly speaking out against the Dominion. However, if you travel to Swindler's Den and fight your way through to Kamat, he will explain to you that Saadia fled Hammerfell after betraying her family. This caused trouble for the city and whatnot. Saadia will be all fine and saved if you clear out Swindler's Den and make sure to kill Kamatu, finishing the quest for you. So as I said earlier, Kamatu is inside Swindler's Den and can be met after clearing out the bandits inside. He will talk to you and tell you that she betrayed the city of Tanith and her noble family and whatnot. For helping them, you can lie to Saadia, convince her to come to the Whiterun stables, where she will be paralyzed and taken away. Both sides are extremely simple, and whatever one you choose has no massive effect, but I am going to tell you two major things to think about here to help sway your decision. There are two key factors that help you understand the situation a bit better and maybe figure out who is the true liar. Is Kamatu and the Alik'r really telling the truth, or is Saadia the innocent victim? So let's figure it out. So you have two things to think about. Hammerfell is the safest place in all of Tamriel from the Aldemeri Dominion. The second treaty of Strathmakai makes sure of this and all. Go look it up. It ensures the Dominion and Empire stay out of Hammerfell, so this makes the lie of Saadia make no sense at all. It also makes the Alik'r lie make no sense either, but why speak out against a faction that has zero control over a country? It doesn't make any sense. Why flee to a country that is full of the very thing you spoke out against in a country that has no control involving what you did speak out against? Saadia's lie doesn't add up at all with any of this. And yes, the Alik'r speak of this, that Saadia betrayed the city, but Hammerfell once again remains okay against the Dominion, so this doesn't make any sense. But for some reason, the mercenary band seems to be a little more believable than the innocent woman, and Kamatu even says that when helping him to never just trust a pretty face, you're better than that. But this is the first thing I wanted to cover. This kind of helps the Alik'r's case, although the reason for hunting her may not be the exact thing told. Saadia started all this with her lie. The second thing I wanted to cover is how you can find an urn in the Hall of Dead in Whiterun with Saadia's belongings in it at some point later in the game after the quest has been completed, if you had joined Kamatu's side. And remember, this can be found later after the quest is done. This signifies that either Bethesda game studios had more planned, or she was killed in a secluded place near Whiterun or very far away from you, and her remains were found and brought back. Either or, Saadia seems to be the villain here, and I more so feel that she is the liar. I never had a good feeling about her, even when I met her for the first time. It takes an edgy woman to pull a knife out on you on your first meeting, and it takes a guilty person to run away from their actions. Why run to Skyrim when the Dominion have control here and not in Hammerfell? Honestly, the whole quest is really confusing, but whatever, man. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and make sure to like, subscribe, share, and all that jazz if you enjoyed. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.